Jones.
We have arrived.
We have arrived. There you go. We're back again and we're chasing bunnies. Back on the Tennessee River, over here with our good friends Jeff Boggess and Mr. Caratali again. You saw us last year. We had a big time. This year, we're gonna jump in the G3. We're gonna hop over there in the river. We're gonna see if we can catch a few swamp rabbits running around over here. So stick with us. We'll be right back. Get him.
I'm gonna tell you something right there.
Good girl.
That is a good.
I gotta get him out of that.
That's a heck of a crappie right there.
Now get out of her way.
That's a good start right there.
Tell you what.
The G3 Sportsman is presented by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
How many we take it?
I'm gonna have eight.
Eight?
I'm gonna have eight. Let Scott, when he gets done there, stand at that gate and he can work okay. What we throw him in there. We'll be
all right, I'll hold the gate and y'all can get the dogs.
Girls and boys.
My favorite time when they're loading the dogs in the kettle.
Little turd.
We got all the dogs loaded up here in the kennel. What we'll do, we're gonna put in right here. The river's kind of low this year. So we're gonna put in right here, and then the river's got several islands over here, and they're big islands. So don't think that we're just gonna go somewhere in this little area or whatnot and just chase a rabbit around a little old patch of ground.
The island we're going to is probably between 90 and 100 acres.
Yeah, so. I mean, and there's no, even if we get a run, there is absolutely no guarantee that we'll get the rabbit.
Oh no, it's
in fact, the rabbit will probably win. I guarantee he's
that's
got
why he's there. He's won.
I guarantee you, it's a 70% chance that the rabbit will win this fight today. I guarantee
yeah.
you.
Yeah.
While you're doing that, just let him go.
Just let him go.
Come on. There you go. Come on. Come on, there you go. Come on. We're putting this Astro dog collar on here. And we're gonna try to get an idea of how these swamp rabbits run. And I don't know if it's gonna work or not, but what we're gonna see is just exactly how the rabbits take off and how they do to get away from these dogs. So it's gonna be kind of cool to watch that on the collar. I've got the GPS receiver here in my pocket, and here in a little bit we'll cut her on and we'll watch and see how that old rabbit just runs us ragged.
That'll be pretty deep.
Yeah, because he will. Now what we've done, we mark our spot right here as our home base. And of course, they're already struck. But you can see right here where we've marked. You can zoom in. This is where we're at. And then that's where the dog will be, right there. You can start to see the dog kind of move off. And we'll be able to watch this trail right here. Wherever they run, it'll just have a route on where this rabbit goes. So it's gonna be pretty neat. This is kind of neat stuff right here. We're on some terrain we hadn't hunted. It's good idea to have these things. That way we kind of know where the dogs are, know the lay of the land. And we'll be watching this periodically and seeing how this is going. But I got to get my gun, get my loaded, everything else. We already got struck.
It's gator tough, strong enough. Keeps on going when the going gets rough. Gator tough, strong enough. Everything you need. Summer, spring, winter, fall. G3 lets you do it all. There's nothing like a gator tough G3. No, there's nothing like a gator tough G3.
Visit G3Boats.com to find your nearest G3 and Yamaha outboard motor dealer.
Some hunters only stand in the bargain line. And there are others who will never stand behind any brand. But some will always stand for quality without compromise. Where do you stand? Fiocchi. What's in your gun?
The hunt doesn't last a day. It starts months earlier. With digital camera, topo mapping, three-axis compass, and satellite imagery, get everything you need for the hunt with Oregon 550T from Garmin.
The Yamaha VMAX SHO. First, it changed the game. Now it's set the standard. But don't take our word for it.
The whole shot was everything they said it was going to be.
And we accelerated from like 50 miles an hour to 70, and it was like that.
So fast. So quiet. I mean, you give it power, and it's just there.
That thing right there is just bad.
The whole shot on it is second to none.
Oh, yeah. It's for real.
Take a demo ride and feel the power yourself. You'll know why we call it the Game Changer.
The segment of the G3 Sportsman is brought to you by G3 Boats, a great catch. Fiocchi Ammunition, what's your game? Abu Garcia, for life. And by Garmin, we'll take you there.
Well, we've just walked out of the field and got here in the edge of these briar thickets, and they pushed a rabbit out of this thick stuff, and they run him up through the middle of it. Sounds like they turned, so we're going to hold tight right here, and that rabbit will throw a big circle and hopefully come back within seeing distance of where he started.
Been rabbit hunting all my life, but I really took it up serious about 7-8 years ago.
You never really had time, did you, with being a game warden?
No, I didn't have time then, so I didn't have dogs.
Yeah.
So I just got the dog after I retired. So.
How long was you game warden?
36 years and 8 months.
36 years and 8 months. Oh,
I hear you. That was a long time.
We're going to, the rabbit is run back to the other side of this thicket and come across. I'm going to get out and try to cut him off from these old stump piles out here. Beat him around this thicket here.
Okay, you see the dogs right up here. We've got one that just jumped right back here. And he come down and crossed right here. You can see where the, let's see, right here. Yeah, you can see where the dogs are right here. And he went back over here. He went back right back over here in this other little thicket right here. And now they're on a little swamp rabbit there.
There.
Somebody already took a shot at him. Did you get him?
Man.
Some of these some of these woodlots and thickets and everything are pretty good size. And another thing I like about using this little Garmin unit right here, this little Astro, is for me to find out when we get separated where everybody is. I can also know that you look at right there, I don't know if you can see that, but I know they're about 160 yards away from me. So I know that if I skirt around this thicket right here, I'll probably run into them.
The thing what got started was we jumped a swamp rabbit about 50 yards over here. The swamp rabbit runs across into this thicket. We come out here, Jeff jumps a rabbit, thinking it was the rabbit that we started with, but it wasn't. He got it. We're still looking for the swamp rabbit. We get on his trail again, and we still hadn't got the swamp rabbit.
Nope.
but we're shooting rabbits, but we still hadn't got the original rabbit that we started to chase. So
he's using these hillbillies for bait.
Yeah, he is. He's throwing his scent off with all these little cottontails right here, but the one we're after is that swamp rabbit.
This is the kind of terrain that we're getting, or the slough, swamp rabbit, that we're getting these rabbits out of. This rabbit we just run out of here came from 50 yards just south of me here, out of a log jam, out in this water. The dogs got out there, got to smell him, run him out.
You're probably thinking that what are we doing out here at night?
Yeah.
Cause this is what you do all the time, isn't it?
Well, the way I work, I've took every opportunity I could get to get out with my dogs. Mm-hmm. It's a kind of like a tradition, or it is a tradition.
Yeah. Well, when you want to let them loose.
And we can just let them loose. We just pulled up here on this river bottom road, seen a rabbit cross the road. We're going to put them in this pine thicket and listen to some pretty music. Just drop them out. Their nose will take over.
There you go, boogers.
You know, this is just another neat thing that you can do with your dogs and what Jeff and him do. It's not about, you know, killing the rabbits or anything else. If anything, he protects most of the rabbits by keeping the coyotes and stuff at bay and whatever. And it takes guys like Jeff and his family and Mr. Tally and all them that really will keep, you know, rabbit hunting and that tradition alive for generations to come. And that's what we need more of. And to sit out here on the tailgate on a moonlit night and let the dogs run and everything, hey, to me,
doesn't get any better.
That's the good stuff right there.
This song, cast your cares away with each passing wave. This song. Yamaha built to last. Ooh, so fish on.
Visit G3Boats.com to find your nearest G3 and Yamaha outboard motor dealer.
It's for those who get up early on weekends and those who'd rather rough it than take it easy. It's for those who know it's not just a sport, but a way of life. The new Food Saver Game Saver vacuum sealing system keeps food fresh up to 5 times longer with a rugged design and 12-volt adapter cord for easy use in the field, ensuring your game and fish is fresh when you need it. The Food Saver Game Saver vacuum sealing system. Fielded fresh. Sealed fresh.
This segment of the G3 Sportsman is brought to you by Beretta. 500 years, one passion. Mossback fish racks. No matter how you stack them, we attract them. Berkeley, catch more fish. Shakespeare, quality fishing tackle since 1897. And by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
Back down here with our boys here, Jeff Bogus, Mr. Carroll Talley, waiting to go. He's just always just antsy, ready to roll. So we can't get started soon enough. Fixing to hit the field down here in the Tennessee River bottoms, and let's get the show on the road right now. That's what we're fixing to do.
Good girl. Come on, let's go. These pine thickets with these briars on the south end give them a lot of cover.
Okay. Zoom in, I'll find the dog where they're at. See where they went.
Mm-hmm.
across the creek. And that's where they're at right now. So they're a pretty good ways from us.
Okay, that's pretty neat.
But it's a pretty good ways. These are neat little deals right here. And you know, most people wouldn't think, you know, you think for your bird dog or your coon dog at night, which boy, would really come in handy.
Yeah.
Wide ranging pointers or something. And but rabbit hunters need this kind of stuff too. You want this kind of thick?
This thick, and they swamp rabbits, they'll run like a deer. I mean, they'll cover a big territory.
That's right.
And
it's not that you can really use it to your advantage as far as let's see if we can head it off and maybe try to kill more rabbits. I don't think it really gives you that much more of an advantage as far as that goes. But what it can do, it can keep up with your dogs and just gives you an idea of just how rangy these rabbits actually are.
Right. Oh yeah. That's like, neat. I wouldn't have thought of putting one on my beagles. I like having them because, you know, you get hung in a slough or on a riverbank somewhere.
That's right.
You know, you'll know where your dog's at.
You can almost not be without one of these anymore. How many hard luck stories have you heard where somebody's lost their dog, didn't know where a road was or whatever else? This can kind of give you an idea because it's got the topographical maps on here. It shows the roads and the terrain and whatnot. Then you know your area. Then you know if the dogs are heading out that way, you're getting close to the road, you know you can run out there and go get them or whatnot. They're starting to trail again right now. So like I said, we're just off a little finger from where we started. We've just made a little small circle.
Oh yeah.
Is all we've done. We've got two in the bag. And so now we're gonna see what this one. We ain't even really got time to even get a drink of water or anything, have we?
No, and then the truck's just.
Yeah, yeah, we can still see the trucks.
300 yards, so.
We can still see the truck, so that's always good. And
it's a good area.
So we'll see, should we maybe get on one on the other, or can you get on the other side?
Well, we're going to work around it because it's deep out there. And I'm going to work them past where this woodcock come up because it gives off a little scent and throws them off.
Okay.
Okay?
All right. Bang! Bang!
Don't get stuck. I seen a swamp rabbit one time cross the creek, waded the creek, and the dogs swam it.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, them dogs up to their bellies right now.
Yeah.
He may skirt to back behind us, though.
Belle's in there looking. She's up trying to get them out.
Yep. She bait. You think that's a swamp rabbit?
I believe it is. There he goes. I think I got him, but I'm sure.
Boy, that was a surprise rabbit, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. I thought they done missed him.
Well, we'll go over there and see if we can find him.
All right, let's go look for him.
There's another hillbilly for the pile.
Yeah, that's a big hillbilly, though.
That's a big one. That's a good
one. It's a fully grown.
He was up in his condo in that stump pile.
Yeah. Well, that's a nice rabbit.
Let's get off and get another one.
I don't have mine on.
I hadn't got my bag. Let's put it in yours. I'm going to pile down.
Where's Scott at? He's no angry.
Oh, Scott's got the bag, doesn't he?
Scott's supposed to be candy.
I think starts in gear. Got to take Mr. Tally his beagle's nest here. Save him on some steps.
Since I've retired, that's the main hobby of mine is fishing and hunting, of course. And you know, this is something that anybody can do, and it's probably one of the better things for grandkids and young kids, and because if you keep them hunting, they're not in the out on the streets doing other stuff. So this is a lot far better than anything else you can be doing.
And you've seen it all.
Nah, I've seen it all. I've seen it all over the period of years. So, and you very seldom see a kid in trouble that really loves to hunt. So that makes a whole lot of difference.
Introducing a revolutionary way to attract fish, the Mossback Fish Rack. From the box to the water, setup is a snap, and you can be fishing in no time. The rough surface on the branches encourages algae growth, and the unique design virtually eliminates hanging hooks. Use the Mossback Fish Rack in your pond, hang it off your dock, or sink it in your local lake. Join the guides, pros, and weekend fishermen who are already reaping the rewards. No matter how you stack them, we attract them. To learn more, visit mossbackrack.com.
I was so sick of him fishing, I ran over his ugly stick with his own truck.
Don't get me wrong, I couldn't be happier that he found a hobby.
Oh, time to go fishing today, Harry!
I'm a peaceful person.
So I gave it to our dog, Sugar, as a chew toy.
Your mama, her husband back!
What is that thing made of?
You know what happened?
Nothing!
Absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
Ugly Stick, tested under some of the harshest conditions on Earth.
Stupid Ugly Stick.
Not bad for a day's work.
I'm gonna need a few more of these for tomorrow.
Catch more fish with Gulp and Gulp Alive. Gulp outfishes anything and everything, including live bait. Gulp looks, feels, and tastes alive.
I'll clear off some more wall space.
That's a lose and a pickup. Hold on. That rabbit's turned. See what's dog? Right here. He's turned back to the right. We walked over their scent. So we turned the rabbit. All right, Tabitha's on it. Right there, see, turned again.
Uh-huh.
You know, another advantage or another reason I really like to run at night is I enjoy feeling with young dogs and training them. And at night, the rabbits use the cover of darkness to get out and feed in these green fields. Well, as I'm coming to an area that I want to run my dogs, I'll catch a rabbit crossing the road. Well, I'll stop and put my dogs out on a hot rabbit track so I don't have to worry about if they're running a deer, an armadillo, or a coon or off game. So it gives me a level of confidence for my dogs and what they're doing. And it's a great tool for starting young dogs. They're gonna line it out again once they get past where we just swung through, and it'll take off. Jaws.
You can hear Tabitha go.
Oh yeah, Tabitha's got a mouth like ringing a bell.
Yeah,
that's
pretty
cool.
That's
a chop mouth dog.
Yeah,
that's pretty cool. Mouth, chop mouth.
It's a year-round sport of what you can do. You can run your dogs, train your dogs. It's always fun when you start out pups and watching them mature and turn into a good trail dog. And I tell you, there's nothing to me more cool than beagles, or as we call them down here, rabbit dogs. But that's all the time we got for this week's show. Hope you enjoyed it. And just remember, we'll be out there somewhere next week, right here on the G3 Sportsman. Thanks for watching. And now we got another one going. I can hear you barking.
Told you.
Been rabbit hunting all day down here in Tennessee. Special treat. Sauger fish fry. Caught right here in the Tennessee River. And homemade hush puppies. Secret family recipe. As good as it gets right there. Guarantee you.
The G3 Sportsman has been brought to you by G3 Boats. A great catch. Fiocchi Ammunition. What's in your gun? Abu Garcia, for life. Food Saver, the number one vacuum sealer. Garmin, we'll take you there. Mossback Fish Racks. Berkeley, catch more fish. Sony. Beretta, 500 years, one passion. Shakespeare. And by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
Well,
I think I got him, but I'm sure.
Hey, look for the camera.
Appropriately named Astro after the George Jetson's dog, Astro.
Astro, I hadn't thought about that.
Yeah,
that's good.
No, I don't carry a gun most of the time. I carry a walking stick or staff, as I guess I should say.